Have you ever wondered what causes red eyes in photographs? Well, in today's video, we'll explore some of the causes and I will give you some advice on how to reduce the red eye effect in photographs. The eyes appear red in photographs when the camera captures the light reflecting off your subject's retinas, when the camera flash is used at night or dim lighting. Light travels through the optical system of the eye, gets focused on the retina, which is a layer of light detecting cells at the back of the eye. When a camera flash goes off, the pupils of your subject's eyes do not have adequate time to constrict in order to be able to reduce the amount of light entering them. Therefore, a large burst of light reaches the retina, is reflected back and is captured by the camera sensor. The red color of the reflex is due to the rich blood supply of the choroid layer of the eye, which is a layer consisting of blood vessels and connective tissue at the back of the eye, which nourishes the retina and gives it its normal red color. The next question you might have is how to reduce it. Do not use the flash if there is enough ambient light to take photographs. You will avoid red eyes in photos. Do not look directly at the camera. Tell your subjects to look slightly away from the lens so that their eyes does not catch the flash at a direct angle. Make the room brighter. The darker the environment, the more dilated the pupil of the subject becomes. Increasing the immediate surrounding light levels can help eliminate red eyes. Turn on your camera's red eye reduction feature. Most smartphone cameras have this feature, which emits short flashes of light in quick succession before the camera actually takes the picture. These light flashes constrict your subject's pupils, allowing lesser amount of light to reflect back from the retina. Use an external or indirect flash. Changing the angle at which the flash fires will prevent light from directly reflecting back into the lens. Make sure your subjects are not drunk. Too much alcohol reduces reaction time in general, but you should also know that it reduces the response time of your pupils. Red eyes are more likely to occur in photographs where the subjects are intoxicated, because their pupils will not constrict fast enough to reduce the amount of light reflected back from the retina. Having only one eye appear red in photos usually means that only one of your subject's eyes, the one that appears red, was staring directly at the camera lens, and the other was positioned at a slightly different angle. One possibility that gives rise to this situation is having a squint, which is a misalignment of the eye. Rarely, red eye in only one eye is indicative of an eye disease like tumor or cataract. If you or a family member consistently has an eye appearing red in photos, consult an eye care practitioner. It is also possible that you may have pupils that are relatively large in size. If you have larger pupils, then you are more likely to have red eyes in photographs. Keep an eye out for occasions where one eye appears red and the other appears bright yellow or whitish. A yellowish or white glow in one eye, called leukochoria, may indicate serious eye conditions or diseases like Coats' disease, cataract, eye infection, or even retinal detachment. If you notice anything unusual about your child's eyes in photos, consult an eye care practitioner immediately. Here's an interesting fact about animal eyes. White, yellow, or green glow reflecting from the eyes of dogs, cats, deer, and other animals is caused by a structure in the back of these animals' eyes called the tapetum lucidum. The tapetum lucidum is a tissue in the eyes of many vertebrates. Lying immediately behind their retina, it acts as a retroreflector. It reflects visible light back through the retina, increasing the amount of light available to the photoreceptors. The tapetum lucidum is the reason behind the superior night vision of some animals. It causes the pupils of these animals to glow in a variety of colors. Hope this video was informative for you and answered some of your questions. Thank you for watching.